Welcome to Algebra 2. We've got section 4.9 today, modeling with polynomial functions. All right, our key concepts today, we're going to skip an introduction on this lesson. Basically, what we're going to do is we're going to look at how polynomial functions can act like quadratic functions did in chapter 3 in modeling sets of data. And again, we use these models to make predictions about where our best situations are or what would happen in the future. So really useful, very real-world applicable math that we're doing here today. Finite differences, these can be used when we have like a table of data to determine what type of function would be best to model this specific data set. When the x values are equally spaced, the differences in y values are called the finite differences, and we looked at this at the end of chapter 3. If the nth differences of these equally spaced data points are non-zero and constant, then the data can be represented by an nth degree polynomial function. So in chapter 3, we looked for the second difference that led us to a second degree polynomial, a quadratic, but now we can go further. For functions of best fit, we enter the data points in the stat menu and plot the data points. Again, we've covered this in chapter 3. Based on the arrangement of the points, we make a decision. Are we going to use quadratic regression, cubic regression, or quartic regression in our calculator? All right, let's look at the first example. This is going to be more algebraic, but this is really the only type of by hand work that we have to do. Most of it's being handled in the calculator this section. All right, so here we want to express a cubic function in factored form, and we can tell by the graph we've got three zeros. Our zeros are x equals negative 6, x equals negative 3, and x equals positive 3. We also have an additional point, the point 0, negative 9. Well, plugging the zeros into the factors, we get x plus 6, x plus 3, and x minus 3. However, we don't know what this a term is. We have an idea that because it's a cubic function and it is rising to the right, falling to the left, our end behavior, that indicates that a should be positive. But we need to use this point to find out definitively what a is equal to. So f of x, that's the height of the function, the y value. We're going to use the y value of that point, and we're going to solve for a. So the x value for that point is 0, 0 plus 6 times 0 plus 3 times 0 minus 3. So negative 9 equals a times, 6 times 9, 54. And divide both sides by negative 54, we find a equals 1/6. So our function is 1/6 times x plus 6 times x plus 3 times x minus 3. Once we find a, we can plug that back into the factored form along with the zeros that we had. All right, example two. Use finite differences to determine the degree of the polynomial, then use technology to find the polynomial function. All right, we want to check and make sure that our x's are equally spaced, and sure enough, we are covering a distance of one between each of those x values. Now let's start looking at the differences. 14 minus negative 5, or negative 14 plus 5 is what that turns into. We get negative 9. Negative 5 minus negative 2. Negative 2 minus 7. Negative 9. 7 minus 34. And 34 minus 91. Negative 57. Now for our second difference, because those did not come out to be constant, we're going to check our next difference. Negative 9 minus negative 3. Negative 3 minus 9. Or negative 3 minus negative 9, sorry. Negative 9 minus negative 27. And negative 27 minus negative 57. Still not constant. So this first row was our first difference, didn't come constant, so we know it's not a first degree polynomial. Our second difference, that would be to test and see if we have a quadratic, those are not constant. Now we're trying our third difference, negative 6 minus 6, 6 minus 18, 18 minus 30, negative 12. So we know we have a third degree polynomial because our third differences were constant. All right, now let's use the calculator to come up with that function. All right, I've changed the resolution, so I hope the calculator is a little bit easier for you to read. We want to enter the points in our stat menu, so stat, and then I hit enter when it said edit. My x values, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the y values that go with them, negative 14, accidentally hit the minus sign, negative 5, negative 2, 7, 34, 91. All right. Now, we already know it's supposed to be third degree, so we don't have to look at all the points plotted out to make an estimate there. We're ready to go right into the equation. So stats, calculate, we want a cubic regression equation, and we hit enter, and there it gives us the A, B, C, and D values that fill in with that regression equation. Okay, and if we wanted to go to y equals, we could go vars, y vars, just vars down 5 statistics, equation, insert our regression equation, and you can see it's 2x cubed minus 3x squared plus 4x minus 5. And it's rounding very, very slightly there. That's just based on its calculations. So let's go back to our regression output, and we will put that answer on the screen. So to answer this question, the function we're looking for is 2x cubed minus 3x squared plus 4x minus 5. Again, the 2, negative 3, 4, and negative 5 coming right from the output on our calculator. Very cool stuff. All right, well, in number 12, we're given a list of points instead of a table. It's helpful to put this in a table so that, again, we can make sure our x values have a equal spacing, and then we can clearly see our y values in order to conduct our differences. So let's see our x values. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7, and 8, and 9. Then our y values, or our outputs, our f of x's, we've got 0, 6, 2, 6, 12, negative 10, negative 114, negative 378, and negative 904. I should have spaced out my x values a little bit more, but really, once we know that they're equally spaced, we don't need the x values anymore until we go to the calculator. All right, the outputs. Let's check first difference, 0 minus 6, 6 minus 2 is a positive 4, 2 minus 6, there's our negative 4, 6 minus 12, 12 minus negative 10, negative 10 minus negative 114, negative 114 minus negative 378, and negative 378 minus negative 904. 26. All right, so not first difference. Let's try second. Negative 6 minus 4. 4 minus negative 4. Negative 4 minus negative 6. Negative 6 minus 22. 22 minus 104. 104 minus 264. 264 minus 526. Okay, so it wasn't a second difference. Let's try third. Negative 10 minus 8. 8 minus 2. 2 minus negative 28. Negative 28 minus negative 82. It's going to be positive 54. Negative 82 minus negative 160. Positive 78. Negative 160 minus negative 262, 162. Sorry, 102. All right, so it wasn't a third difference. Let's try fourth. Negative 18 minus negative 6. Negative 6 minus 30. 30 minus 54. 54 minus 78. 78 minus 102. So I'm seeing a lot of negative 24s here, which leads me to believe that I did some arithmetic wrong here. Let's just double check. Ah, I found it. It was right here. 8 minus 2 should have been a positive 6. Negative 18 minus 6 would make that negative 24. And then 6 minus 30 would make that negative 24. So if we see numbers start to repeat, we want to be able to check our work in the step up above, because we might have slipped up on something. I definitely did right there. So we can tell this is a fourth degree polynomial. Let's go to the calculator. All right. And in our calculator, once we fire it up, we will clear the screen, go back to the stat menu. We want to edit our lists. And if you toggle to the up here where it says L2, if you hit clear and enter, it wipes out that whole list, which is helpful. So you can use the arrows and clear when the whole list is selected. Makes it much easier than deleting each individually. All right, L1, our x coordinates. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. The y coordinates. We've got 0, 6, 2, 6, 12, oops, negative 10. Oh, come on. So after 12, we had a negative 10, then a negative 114, then a negative 378. And finally, a negative 904. Back in the stat menu, we want to calculate. This is a fourth degree, so we want a quartic regression equation, option 7. And we hit enter, and there it gives us our coefficient. So I'm going to copy that into PowerPoint real quickly. And we get f of x equals negative 1x to the fourth plus 13x cubed minus 58x squared plus 104x minus 58. So it's a little bit of a process, but it's really neat how simple subtraction can give us so much information about how a function is behaving. Really, really cool. Again, I had not been exposed to this concept of finite differences before teaching this class, and it's something I really like. It tells us an awful lot about how our data is behaving. So, very cool. And of course, it's always fun to use the calculator. That's doing a lot of work for us. All right, we're at our final example today. The table shows the ages of cats and their corresponding ages in human years. Find a polynomial function for the data for the first 8 years of a cat's life. Use the model to estimate the age in human years of a cat that is 3 years old. Unfortunately, we do not have equally spaced x values, so we cannot use the finite difference thing. We cannot use that process to determine what degree. We're missing a couple of data points here that would have really helped us out. So this is going to be purely calculator based. And if we pull up the calculator, clear out the screen, go back to our stat menu and edit those lists. Let's clear out those lists. All right, and for list one, my x values, I've got 1, 2, 4, 6, 7, and 8. For the y values, I've got 15, 24, 32, 40, 44, and 48. Now, they just say polynomial. They don't say cubic, they don't say quartic, they don't say quadratic or anything like that. So we're going to have to look at these points. So I'm going to hit second y equals and turn my first stat plot on. And then graph. Oops, I still have a function typed in. Hit graph. I don't see any of my data points. So I will hit zoom 9, which will be zoom stat. And you can see there are the data points. And it looks like it's bending and then kind of leveling out a little bit and then starting to maybe bend again. It looks like a cubic function to me, because if it were a quadratic, we're seeing the end behavior that's indicative of a cubic function, but it's not quite a straight line. So we're going to do a cubic regression, stat, calc, cubic regression, and hit enter, and there is our function. I'm going to copy that into the PowerPoint just to refer back to. All right, and now in our y equals, we're trying to estimate the age of a cat that is 3 years old. How old is that cat in human years? So if we insert our regression equation, vars statistics eq regression eq, and then we hit graph, you can see that cubic really does a nice job of approximating our data. That shows us that we made the right choice in what polynomial we chose, what regression we chose. And we can do calc value. When x equals 3, you see that the height is 28.608. And it looks like from our data set, between the ages cat years of 2 and 4, the age in human years is between 24 and 32. So this answer perfectly makes sense. I'm just going to grab that calculator screen really quickly. All right, and let's answer the question. So based on the output of our calc value, which we got from our regression equation, we can say that the cat is 28.608 years old. All right, here's a look at your assignment for section 4.9.